Let us open our Bible to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 6. Jeremiah 6. Judah's sins. Judah's sins. Jeremiah 6, verses 1 to 7. The invasion of Judea. Verses 1 to 3. Jeremiah belongs to the tribe of Benjamin. So he sends his particular warnings of Yahweh's approaching justice to his own tribe, as he previously warned in Jeremiah 5 verse 15, this justice is coming from the north. Verses 4 to 7, justice against Jerusalem appears to be coming in the form of a well-planned, premeditated attack on a nation that has continually defied Yahweh. Whatever methods are used, it is vain to contend with Yahweh's judgments. The more we indulge in the pleasures of this life, the more we unfit ourselves for the troubles of this life. The Chaldean army will break in upon the land of Judah, and in a little time devour all. The day is coming when those careless and secure in sinful ways will be visited. It is folly to trifle when we have eternal salvation to work at, and the enemies of that salvation to fight against. But they were thus eager, not that they might fulfill Yahweh's counsels, but that they might fill their own treasures. Yet God thereby served his own purposes. The corrupt heart of man in its natural state casts out evil thoughts, just as a fountain casts out waters. It is always flowing, yet always full. The God of mercy is reluctant to depart even from a provoking people, and is honest with them, that by repentance and reformation they may prevent things from coming to extremity. Jeremiah 6 verses 9 to 17. The justice of God's proceedings. Verses 8 to 9. Yahweh likens his power and ability to completely destroy the people to those of a good harvester who picks all the grapes off a vine. Verses 9 to 11. The people are accused of not hearing the word of their Creator, and Yahweh has had enough. Verses 12 to 13. Jeremiah prophesies specific details of what can be expected from the Babylonian invasion. And again, Yahweh blames each of the citizens of Judah for the nation's collective sin. Verses 14 to 15. Yahweh's accusations toward the religious leaders are telling. They perform rituals and chant words, but their spirits are not pure. When Yahweh arises to take vengeance, no sinners of any age or rank or of either sex can escape. They were set upon the world and wholly carried away by the love of it. If we judge of this sin by Yahweh's word, We find multitudes in every station and rank given up to it. Those who flatter us in a sinful way are to be reckoned our worst and most dangerous enemies. Oh, that people would be wise for their souls. Ask for the old path, the way of godliness and righteousness has always been the way Yahweh has owned and blessed. Ask for the old path set forth by the written word of Yahweh. When you have found the good way, go on in, go on in it. You will find abundant recompense at your journey's end. But if people will not obey the voice of Yahweh and flee to his appointed refuge, it will plainly appear at the day of judgment that they are ruined because they reject God's word. Verses 10 to 21. This section both condemns Judah for not heeding Jeremiah's warnings and expands on the reasons provided earlier for Yahweh's judgment. Verses 16 to 20. The people of Judah had the chance to listen to the priests and the prophets who spoke truth and to return to the true God, but they refused, and chose to continue sacrificing to Yahweh while living in a way that did not bring him glory. Jeremiah 6 verses 18 to 30. All methods used to amend them had been without success. Verses 24 to 26. Peace and normal life for the nation are quickly coming to an end. Verses 27 to 30. Jeremiah's final metaphor of this chapter likens his church for Yahweh, who do not deserve Yahweh's judgment, to a metal worker searching for good, strong metal among weaker metal. The process includes hot fires stoked with bellows. The metal worker burns without finding any good metal. Yahweh rejects their outward services as worthless to atone for their sins. Sacrifice and incense were to direct them to a mediator, but when offered to purchase a license to go on in sin, they provoke Yahweh. The sins of God's professing people make them an easy prey to their enemies. They do not dare show themselves. Saints may rejoice in hope of Yahweh's mercy, in hope of Yahweh's mercies, though they see them only in the promise. Sinners must mourn for fear of Yahweh's judgments, though they see them only in the threats. They are the worst of rebels, and they are all corrupters. Sinners soon become tempters. Sinners are compared to ore, supposed to have good metal in it, but which proves all dross. Nothing would prevail to separate between them and their sins. Reprobate silver shall they be called, useless and worthless. When warnings, corrections, rebukes, and all means of grace leave people unrenewed, they will be left as rejected of Yahweh to everlasting misery. Let us pray then that we may be refined by Yahweh as silver is refined. Know this, and the Lord Yahweh will bless you. Let us take these prayer points. Let us pray. Jeremiah 6. Flee for safety, people of the world, the first church, for disaster looms out of the north, even terrible destruction. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh will destroy the world, the first church, so beautiful and delicate. In the name of Yeshua, shepherds will with their flocks come against the world, the first church. In the name of Yeshua, they pitch their tents, covens of darkness, around the world, the first church, each tending his own portion. In the name of Yeshua, the northern shepherds arise, attack at night, and destroy the fortresses of the world, the first church. In the name of Yeshua, the attackers cut down the trees and build the siege rams against the welfare church. In the name of Yeshua, for this church must be punished. It is filled with oppression. In the name of Yeshua, as a well pours out its waters, so the world first church pours out her wickedness. In the name of Yeshua, violence and destruction resound in her. Her sickness and wounds are ever before Yahweh. In the name of Yeshua, take warning, O world first church, or Yahweh will turn away from you and make your land desolate, so no one can live in it. In the name of Yeshua, let us glean the remnant of Yahweh's peoples as thoroughly as a vine. In the name of Yeshua, let us pass our hand over the branches again, like one gathering grapes and in search of the righteous ones. In the name of Yeshua, in the world first church, their uncircumcised ears are closed, so they cannot hear, and Yahweh cannot speak and give them warning. In the name of Yeshua, the word of Yahweh is offensive to them. They find no pleasure in it. In the name of Yeshua, Yahweh Shaphat, pour out your wrath on their children in the streets and on the young men gathered together. In the name of Yeshua, both husband and wife will be caught in it, and the old, those weighed down with years. In the name of Yeshua, turn their houses over to others, Lord Yahweh, together with their possession, when you stretch out your hand against those who live in the land. In the name of Yeshua, from the least to the greatest, all are greedy for pain, for gain. Prophets and priests alike all practice deceit. In the name of Yeshua, where brokenness is needed, they dress the wound of Yahweh's people as though it were not serious. In the name of Yeshua, peace, peace, they say, when there is no peace in people's lives. In the name of Yeshua, they are not at all ashamed of their detestable conduct. They do not even know embarrassment. In the name of Yeshua, Lord Yahweh, let them fall among the fallen. Bring them down and break them when you punish them. In the name of Yeshua, Lord Yahweh, bring disaster on these people, the fruit of their schemes, because they have not listened to your words and have rejected you, O Lord, in the name of Yeshua. For Yahweh does not care about facts and about fast and offerings. Their sacrifices are not acceptable in the name of Yeshua. Their sacrifices do not please Yahweh, for their hearts are unclean in the name of Yeshua. Therefore, Yahweh puts obstacles before the people of the world, the first church, in the name of Yeshua. Parents and children alike will stumble over them. Neighbors and friends will perish in the name of Yeshua. For an army is coming from the northern land. A great nation is stirred up from the ends of the earth in the name of Yeshua. They are armed with bows and spear. They are cruel and show no mercy in the name of Yeshua. They sound like the roaring sea as they ride on their horses in the name of Yeshua. They come like men in battle formation to attack the willful church in the name of Yeshua. Mourn with bitter wailing, O people of the willful church, for suddenly the destroyer will come upon you in the name of Yeshua. Because you are all hardened rebels going about to slander, Yahweh pours his wrath upon you in the name of Yeshua. You are called rejected silver because Yahweh has rejected you. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Thank you, Father Yahweh, for your word of wisdom, your word of guidance, your word of teaching, your word of enlightenment, your word of spiritual strengthening, your word of spiritual growth, your word of spiritual elevation. Thank you, Father Yahweh, for that you heard our confession, you heard our prayers of repentance. And after you heard, you took away our dirty garment of sin and iniquity, and you dressed with a brand new garment, a garment cleaner than anything else, even the garment of your own spirit. Thank you, Father Yahweh, that you heard our cries, our supplication, our requests, our prayers. Thank you, Father Yahweh, for your endless love to us. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy, for your grace. And thank you, Yahweh, for your faithfulness. Thank you, Lord, for your forgiveness. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you all the praise. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Now, let us pray, our closing prayers. Let us pray the prayer our good Lord Yeshua, the Messiah, left us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. That will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us of evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. We seal all our prayers with the blood of Yeshua. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Lord, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Lord, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Father Yahweh, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Lord, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Yahweh, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Father, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Lord, thank you for your answers to our prayers. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, we pray. Now, with the waving of our hands to our loving Father Yahweh, let us shout seven joyful hallelujah, seven victorious hallelujah, seven thanksgiving hallelujah to our good Father Yahweh. Alléluia. 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 May Father Yahweh bless each and every one at this worship place on this prayer. And may Father Yahweh bless you as you go out. May He bless you as you're coming. May Father Yahweh make it permanent, His answers to your prayers. May Father Yahweh lay His right hand upon you. May He dress you in His cloud of glory. May He surround you with His edge of fire. May Father Yahweh fill you with His fire of deliverance. May Father Yahweh pour upon you and fill you to the brim with His living water. May Father Yahweh settle you on your promised land, the land that flows with milk and honey, the most beautiful of lands. May He settle you with good health, happiness, prosperity, success, and eternal life. Go in peace. May the peace of our Lord, Yahshua the Messiah, be with you all. Amen. Hallelujah.